Hi, everyone. I'm Linda Lindberg. I'm the new Senior Director for Safety for PG&E, and I'm really excited to be here. I've only been here like not even quite 3 months. I actually come from Colorado, born and raised in Denver, and so this is a huge change for me coming to San Francisco and to PG&E. I was actually with Xcel Energy for 35 years, and the last 15 of that was actually focused on safety and training. And a little different at Xcel Energy. We had 8 different states. We had 8 different PUCs to deal with. We had 7 different unions that we needed to build relationships with. But it was still all around the same basic stuff, safety and training. So with that, I wasn't looking for a job. PG&E came and found me, and I'm delighted that they did. I have absolutely no buyer's remorse. In fact, speaking of buyers, I actually bought a new house over here in Clayton. I'll be moving in August there, and so as you can imagine, Colorado to California, twice the house for half the money was in Colorado, and here I've got half the house for twice the money, so I'm around for a while. Let me just tell you a little bit about my personal observations since I've been here for only 3 months. I've really found that people here really want to do the right thing. Very, very passionate about safety, which is a great piece for me to start my work with in looking at how do we go about changing a safety culture. We've had some very serious tragedies here at PG&E, and I've experienced those when I was at Xcel Energy also. You never get over the tragedy part, but it gives you an opportunity to really get passionate about where you want to go with safety, because you don't ever want to go back to having any of those tragedies happen again. I've also learned that we're doing some really good things around safety at this company, and that really excites me too. That tells me that you're all very passionate about it, and being part of shared services now, I want to put a little vote out there for you guys. I would love it if we were able to be the role models around safety here at PG&E and just blow away the other lines of business when it comes to safety. So, in general, how are we going to actually get there on our safety journey? We've really got to take a look at the culture, and there's a lot of things that you'll see that start changing around the culture. We're really going to focus on the safety climate initially, and some of the things that you're very familiar with, the safety pledge, the rules to live by, those are changing a little bit to really help us make an even bigger commitment to public safety and employee safety. So you'll see that the safety pledge that you're all familiar with for several years now changes actually into a commitment around safety, not just for our personal selves, but for the company. The company has a commitment, and that was based on feedback we got from many of you, that if I'm going to make a personal commitment, I want to see the company making a personal commitment around safety. So you'll see that. You'll also see that we added some rules to live by to really encompass the whole company. So we've got things around excavations, a number of different changes there. It's really now focused on everyone and everything that we do, public and employee-wise. So you'll also see some major initiatives that are starting around safety. They're things like leadership observations, peer-to-peer observations, near-hit programs, which frankly I'd rather call good catches. How do we communicate about safety? You'll see a number of initiatives around those things, and I need all of your help in grabbing onto those initiatives, making the commitment we need to do for safety. I've been really excited with the commitment and the passion that I see with Des Bell as our leader, and I think he really has been enjoying taking over safety as the lead safety officer for the company. The biggest thing is the change management piece. All of us can be resistant at times to various pieces of change. We have got to get behind the safety. We don't want any of us hurt. We don't want any of the public hurt based on what our company does. What really hit me the other day, Chris Johns said to some of the leaders that Every person you see out on the street is one of our customers, and that's what makes us a little more unique as PG&E than with other utilities. And we've got to continue making this commitment to safety. I can't do it by myself. I don't have all of the answers. I need all of you to help me. I need you to become safety ambassadors along with me, and together we'll be able to get there.